You've probably heard that old piece of showbiz wisdom, never work with children or animals. And sure, children, we get. Children get grouchy, they tire easily, nobody needs to hire real kid actors. You can just get Andy Serkis to play them with motion capture. But animals? Come on. Movie animals are great. In fact, they're often more compelling than their human counterparts. Certainly more cuddly. In this video, we're going to be looking at a bunch of real animal sidekicks who totally stole the show. And none of them are played by Andy Serkis, as far as we know. Poor James Gunn, he gets his high-profile comeback gig after some unpleasant online controversy. He writes a wild script, assembles a huge cast, makes a well-received action film, and then the whole show gets upstaged by a single rodent. Yes, we're talking about Sebastian, the beloved pet rat of Ratcatcher 2 from this year's The Suicide Squad. And well, yes, just look at this little fella. Actress Daniela Melchior fell in love with him. The rest of the cast fell in love with him. The crew fell in love with him. Twitter really fell in love with him. Though technically, when we say the film was upstaged by a single rodent, that's not quite accurate. Sebastian was actually played by a trio of identical rats named Jaws, Squeaky, and Crisp Rat. Get it? Like Chris Pratt? We're not sure what the real Chris Pratt did to James Gunn to deserve that, but hey, it's a solid gag.
Don't calm down with the rats!
Considering how closely The Hangover Part 2 sticks to the plot of The Hangover, we must admit that we struggle to remember that many details about the actual movie. Except for the monkey, of course. Now, contrary to popular belief, this is not the same capuchin that played Ross's monkey, Marcel, in Friends. That monkey was played by a female capuchin called Katie. The monkey from The Hangover Part 2 was played by a totally different female capuchin called Crystal. Got it? Although interestingly, you may have also seen Crystal on TV before. She played the very maturely named pin-stealing simian Annie's Boobs in beloved sitcom Community. We wonder if Katie and Crystal have ever met. Do they have a supportive relationship as female monkeys in a tough industry? Or are they feuding on Instagram? The people must be told. Let's grab our hearts, brains, and courage and shoot back in time. There's a whole lot of spectacle in the iconic 1939 Wizard of Oz, from Judy Garland's beautiful singing to the transition from black and white to Technicolor, to the Munchkins, the Wicked Witch, and the glittering green beauty of Oz itself. And a little dog, too. As is frequently the case with screen animals, Dorothy's beloved male dog Toto was actually played by a girl dog, although the film was such a hit that the dog's owner ended up changing the pup's name from Terry to Toto. Terry was also reportedly paid a higher weekly salary than some of the actors working on the picture. The interspecies pay gap, it seems, is very real. Okay, so this is a list of movie animals, but does it count if the animal in question is technically playing an alien? Well, it's our list, so we say it does. Goose was undoubtedly one of the highlights of Captain Marvel, an extremely cute cat. Granted, she turned out to be a hyper-violent, eye-gouging flurkin, but it's honestly pretty hard to hold that against her. Behind the scenes, Goose was actually portrayed by a couple of different cats, and sadly, neither of the film's stars were particularly keen on the arrangement. Brie Larson is allergic to cats, and Samuel L. Jackson apparently just doesn't really like animals. Maybe he's too much of a badass, or maybe snakes on a plane soured him on non-humans in general. Luckily, Ben Mendelsohn, aka Talos, loves cats. So Goose had at least one friendly face among the cast, even if that face was scary and green. But while Goose was undoubtedly a cute cat, our next entry might have her beat. When we first heard that genius sketch comedians Key and Peele would be starring in their first movie, and that the movie would be about a cat that gets kidnapped by drug dealers, they certainly had our curiosity. Then we saw the cat, and suddenly they had our attention. Hold up, does this script not have, like, a pun about curiosity killing the cat? Okay, whatever. At the risk of starting a fight in the comment section, we're going to make a statement. As far as we're concerned, Keanu, feline star of 2016 movie, Keanu, is the cutest cat ever to appear on the big screen. Or the small screen, come to that. I mean, just look at him. Honestly, just look at that cat. We don't have anything more to say. It's beyond words. Or puns, apparently. There's a lot to be said about Ron Burgundy. Iconic mustache, mini leather-bound books, an apartment smelling of rich mahogany, flute. But who cares about all that? We want to talk about his adorable dog, Baxter. As animal trainers will tell you, finding a dog with real natural comic timing isn't the easiest thing in the world, and you wouldn't necessarily have expected it in this case. The dog who played Baxter was called Peanut, and he was a rescue dog who had suffered terrible abuse.
You know how to cut to the core of me, Baxter.
Luckily, he was rescued by a kindly animal trainer and spent many happy years performing at Universal Studios animal shows, where he was a crowd favorite. And then, of course, he was cast in Anchorman. And we've all been in a glass case of emotion ever since. Okay, so having just said it can be hard to find dogs with good comic timing, here's another dog with just really good comic timing. Jim Jarmusch's 2016 movie Patterson was, as you might expect from Jim Jarmusch, an odd movie. An understated, deadpan film in which the understated, deadpan Adam Driver played an understated, deadpan bus driver who wrote understated, deadpan poetry. And somehow, the character's bulldog Marvin, played by a female bulldog named Nellie, was just as understated and deadpan as the movie around her. Just look at her reaction when he comes home from work. That's a real talent, folks. Okay, look, just because this is our third consecutive entry about a dog with good comic timing, it doesn't mean we were wrong to say that it's hard to find them, okay? This is the last one, honestly. And what a performer he was. Obviously, nobody could really upstage Jim Carrey in The Mask. The man's human silly putty. Nobody could really upstage Jim Carrey in anything, at least not during his imperial phase in the 1990s. But we would definitely say that Max the Dog's performance as Milo has stood the test of time, just as much as Carrey's whirlwind turn as Stanley Ipkiss. It's the little details, the way he cocks his head, the way he hides under the covers when his owner changes into a madman with a bright green face, the way he jumps up to reach those bars. And you might be surprised to know that this was the only major starring role that Max ever played. A one-hit wonder of the very good boy kind. If you were putting together a list of the scariest goats in movie history, who would be number one? It's a hotly contested field, of course, but we're going to go with Black Phillip, the frankly terrifying goat from 2015's horror endurance test, The Witch. Now, while it might be tricky to find a dog with good comic timing, we would guess that it's probably quite easy to find a scary goat, because goats are often pretty bad-tempered beasts. And from the sound of things, Charlie the Goat was no exception. He was reportedly extremely aggressive and hard to control during the filming of The Witch, in which director Robert Eggers bluntly stated that the goat was, quote, a f***ing nightmare to work with. But hey, maybe he was just a method actor. You heard it here first, Black Phillip, the Daniel Day-Lewis of movie goats. This final entry, rather than being a specific performance, is a celebration of one of the most legendary animal stars in the history of the movies. Everybody raise a glass to the late, great Bart the Bear. Sure, the dogs, cats, goats, rats, and monkeys on this list were fun in one or two movies. They had their brief moments in the sun. But have any of them worked with Morgan Freeman, Robert Redford, Brad Pitt, Anthony Hopkins, Steven Seagal, and Alec Baldwin? Do any of them have careers spanning 20 years? No, they don't. There's a reason this guy was called the John Wayne of bears. For two decades, if Hollywood wanted a bear, this was who they called. R.I.P. Bart, we shall not see his like again. And if that list of accolades wasn't enough, did you know that Bart the Bear once co-presented an Academy Award? Well, he did. It was 1998, the category was sound effects editing, and the co-star? Oh, just Mike Myers. Sebastian the Rat wishes he had that kind of star power.